Hello students, welcome to N5 Minutes. Today we are going to start with a new module, complex variable. Now complex variable is nothing but in semester 1, that is in maths 1, we have gone through complex number. So when you say about a complex number, so that means complex number is nothing but we say as z, that is x plus iy. So it's a combination of real and imaginary. Now, what is exactly complex variable? Now, complex variable is nothing but also said to be complex function. So here, as we have z is nothing but x plus iy, we are going to define a new variable. That variable is nothing but w, which is function of z. So w is that variable which is said to be complex variable and which is a function of z. So obviously, when it is a function of imaginary and real number, that means it is a function of z, it is a function of complex number. So that means obviously, w will be again a combination of real plus imaginary, where u is said to be real part and v is said to be imaginary part. Now, example, suppose I say w is z square. That means we know that w is now function of z. It's a function, square function is of z. So if you want u and v from this function, or if you want to check that whether w is function of u and v, then in the place of z, you need to replace x plus iy. So I get w is equal to x plus iy the whole square, which I get as x square plus 2i xy plus I square y square, which I finally get as x square plus I 2xy minus y square. That's my w. So now here I can say x square minus y square as real I 2xy. That's my w, where we got the first term, which is a real term without I term, is u, and the second term with I, it's v. So I got u as x square minus y square and v as 2xy. So we understood one thing, that is when we say w is a function of z and z is a function of x and y, that means when you say w is also function of u and v, and u is a function of x and y, v is a function of x and y. So now here, when one variable is dependent on two variables, two independent variables, I can say, that means obviously we can't apply direct differentiation. Now why I'm talking about differentiation is, in further videos, in the further lectures, you can see here we have to check whether your function is differentiable, whether your function is continuous. So for that you require to differentiate. That's why when you talk about differentiation, we can't apply direct differentiation because there are two variables. So we need to use partial differentiation. So for this, I request you should be a good in partial differentiation. I will be revising partial differentiation. With a small differentiation you require it, and I can say hope you understood what is complex function. So here we are going to continue with complex variable, in which you will be checking analytic function. That is, what is exactly analytic function is, what is exactly we need complex function in my further videos. Thank you for watching in 5 minutes.